OneDrive Backup versus using OneDrive for backup, even though OneDrive isn't a backup. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Yes, that's an incredibly confusing title. Microsoft has almost gone out of their way to make this topic confusing. So I'm going to take a couple of minutes and basically try and define when OneDrive is and isn't a backup and which OneDrive backup you should avoid at all costs. Now, I am going to mention a couple of previous articles that I've written. They're out on askleo.com. I've outlined how you should avoid the OneDrive backup feature like the plague. However, I've also talked about how you can use OneDrive for nearly continuous backup. And yet, there's a third article that describes how OneDrive, by itself, isn't really a backup. Here's the thing. These are all different things. These are three completely different and unrelated things. The source of confusion, of course, is that they all use the word backup. So, let's start by very quickly reviewing exactly what it is that OneDrive does. Its fundamental feature, the reason for its existence, is that it is a file synchronization application. That means its primary job is to keep files in two locations in sync with one another. So, if you change a file in the OneDrive folder on your PC, that change is then reflected in OneDrive.com online. Similarly, if you change a file in OneDrive.com online, that change is then reflected in the OneDrive folder on your PC. And I want to be clear, change here means adding or editing or even deleting a file. Do any of those things in one place and it will be mirrored in the other. That's it. That's all. That is OneDrive in a nutshell. Make a change here, and that change is automatically made over there. All right, now let's talk about these three OneDrive backups we've been talking about. There's automatic file synchronization, which I just described, that kind of backs up your work in progress in close to real time. You're working on a document. You make a change to that document on your PC, you write that change to disk, and that change gets reflected online. OneDrive itself, however, is still a single point of failure. So you can't really count on it as a true, long-term, complete backup system. And then there's OneDrive's backup feature, which is something completely separate. It's something that actually has to be turned on. It tries to leverage file synchronization, but it introduces a level of confusion and the potential for data loss. So let's look at each one of these in a little bit more detail. Imagine the following scenario. You're working on an important document that's saved somewhere within your OneDrive folder. Each time you change that document, each time you write it to disk, OneDrive automatically notices and then automatically uploads the changes to OneDrive.com, where they're reflected in the copy of that file that's online. Okay? Now, imagine your hard drive dies, or you lose your laptop when you're traveling. You lose everything, right? Except you don't. The document you've been working on is still at OneDrive.com online. You replace the hard drive or the computer. You download the file and you resume where you left off. It's as if nothing happened to the document at all, because nothing did. OneDrive file synchronization was acting as a kind of backup, copying your file online as you made changes. That's using OneDrive for backup. Now, imagine you're working on an important document stored somewhere in your OneDrive folder. Again, as before, changes are continuously reflected in the copy of the document online. Now imagine that your Microsoft account is compromised. A hacker gains access, and before you know it, they delete everything in your OneDrive. Since OneDrive is synchronized with your PC, remember, that's the primary function of OneDrive, then everything's deleted on your PC as well. All of the copies of your important document are gone. In this scenario, OneDrive is very much one place. And as we know, if it's in only one place, it's not backed up. OneDrive did not protect you from losing your data. That's not a backup. To add the confusion, Microsoft is pushing very, very heavily a feature that they call backup in OneDrive. Now, when you allow this feature to be turned on, and I gotta say, it's really hard to sometimes avoid it being turned on, even though you might not want it to be. But when the feature is turned on, your documents folder, previously outside of OneDrive, is moved inside your OneDrive folder. Your pictures folder, previously outside of OneDrive, is moved inside your OneDrive folder. Your desktop folder, again, previously outside of OneDrive, is moved inside of your OneDrive folder. And indeed, other folders may be affected. That's it. That's all that this feature does. But in that doing, oh my, can it cause problems. Microsoft calls this a backup because once these folders are within the OneDrive folder, OneDrive synchronizes their contents with your OneDrive.com storage online. This is how OneDrive serves as a kind of backup, as I described above. The problem is that this happens regardless of how much online storage you have and whether your existing files exceed that capacity. What's worse, if you turn the feature off, the contents of those folders are not moved back. You'll still exceed your online capacity and risk actually losing your data. I keep calling this the OneDrive backup feature in quotes because it's not a feature at all. It should not be turned on, no matter how strongly Microsoft suggests it. And they do suggest it strongly. It's simply too risky and too confusing. You can use OneDrive as a kind of backup, as I outlined above, but you don't need this additional backup feature to do it. All right. What I like to call OneDrive as part of a healthy breakfast. This kind of backup and the thing that Microsoft calls a backup only make things confusing and can lead to data loss. What to do instead? Here's my suggested recipe for a healthy backup strategy that includes using OneDrive. First, create a monthly full image backup to an external drive using a tool like Macrium Reflect or Easus To Do or any of a number of other similar tools. Then also, create a daily incremental image backup using that same tool, again, to your external drive. Optionally, you can enable file history. Now, save all of your work in progress somewhere within the OneDrive folder on your machine. Make sure the OneDrive app is running and synchronizing with OneDrive.com online. Full protection against almost any disaster. And the OneDrive backup feature was never turned on. Now, another alternative, of course, is to avoid using OneDrive completely. Given how hard Microsoft is pushing OneDrive, you might think it can't be done, but in reality, it is possible. Bottom line, don't put any files anywhere within the OneDrive folder. That's really all you need to do. If there are files that aren't within the OneDrive folder, then they are not affected by OneDrive. Just keep everything in other folders. instead of files being somewhere within C:\users username OneDrive, the default location of your OneDrive folder, create your own folder like C:\users username not OneDrive. Avoid the standard folders like documents because of the risk that OneDrive's backup feature could accidentally be enabled, moving them into OneDrive even though you don't want them there. Now, you can also take some additional steps. You can change the default Save As location in your applications, again, to a folder that is not within your OneDrive folder. You can turn off any options in your applications to save files to OneDrive, regardless of whether a specific folder is mentioned. This is particularly true of Microsoft Office applications. Sign out from the OneDrive app. Just know that Microsoft might sign you in again if you do something else Microsoft account related on your machine. And finally, yeah, uninstall the OneDrive app completely. Again, my only caution here is that I have heard that Microsoft may reinstall the app with subsequent updates or upgrades. Bottom line here is that OneDrive can be a useful tool when used properly. Unfortunately, to do that, you've got to avoid Microsoft's recommendations and strong-arm tactics. It's really worth taking the time to understand how OneDrive works. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178091. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.